Alistair here and in such numbers? How does His Eminence not...
I overheard your conversation. These people do not convince easily. No matter. We feared it would come to this. Listen to me. There's something you must do. You must... you must kill them.
What?
The
but why the...
Because he's... You are with me then. It is...
I see what must be done. I will bloody my hands.
Do not worry. We will not let their sacrifice be in vain.
Daniel, are you mad? You're going to go along with this?
The Duke gave such an order, Leonar. And you would carry it out?
Open your eyes. We cannot win if we are unwilling to dirty our hands.
Ours is to follow orders. I swore an oath before the Duke, before the realm.
Listen to you. If I close my eyes, I think I spoke with the Galgastani.
The Duke would sacrifice these people as a piece in some great game. Our Lord has betrayed us all. To think I was willing to give my life for such a man. What a fool I was.
Then you stand apart, Vice. You will not join us?
Damn right! These people have done nothing. Where's the justice in killing them?
I did not think you want to abdicate duty, Ravnus. To break faith with Lord and Realm.
I break no faith. I renounce the Duke. I renounce you all!
I always thought to find you at my side the day the Wallister won their freedom. But if men of our own blood would stand against us, Why should I expect more of you?
Am I not Wallister?
Wallister descended from Galgastani's stock. But the fault is mine. I should not have placed such faith in one of mingled blood.
How dare you?
Every victory comes at a price. Can't you see that? People are dull wits. The sacrifice must be great to wake them from their languor.
And you, Kashua, will you follow in this madness?
I will ever stand with Denim.
From this day, you and I are enemies.
Kill them all! No Wallister leaves this place alive!
Galgastani reinforcements, deal with them. Leave the townsfolk to me.
More from you, Denim. A man who places ends before means treads a dangerous path. The shame is mine for daring to hope. On my honor, you are my foe, Denim.
I just can't believe you have Galgastani to...
You feel yourself betrayed? You'd heed blood over word and action. Can the light of deed not pierce the shadow of one's birth? I believe it can. I will not believe otherwise.
I just can't believe it.
Now, her blood's not mixed of her own doing, boy. I myself am not of the common race, though I can't say as I've met misfortune on that account.
Just luck, perhaps.
I hadn't considered that. But there's time for considering later. We've more pressing matters.
Does not yet require my soul, then what? Am I to be a shepherd to these youths?
I'll kill you by my own hands, Denim. I swear it!
There is blood on my hands. How long till it lies on my heart?
Three weeks had passed since the massacre at Balmamusa. Consumed with revenge, the Wallister took to the battlefield, wresting large swaths of territory from Galgastani control. The Duke's gambit was a success. Yet not all went as the Duke had intended. Though the atrocity galvanized the Wallister, those in the Galgastani camp who opposed their own Hierophant Balbatos did not rise to action. Worse, whispers of the truth behind what happened had begun to spread throughout Galgastan on the lips of Vice and his men. Where the Duke had sought to sow discord, a new sense of unity now grew among the Galgastani people. But the stalemate of forces along the Sonji Weald showed no signs of yielding clear victory to either side. Hoping to strike a decisive blow, the Duke pushed towards Balbatos' stronghold at Kuritanai, a daring, some said reckless, attempt to take the keep. Meanwhile, Denim arrived at the ruins of Balmamusa with orders to harry the enemy's flank.
I hear no alarm, sister. I think we made it.
By the look of things, the Galgastani can't have stationed many men here. The fewer we must kill to be done with this business, the better.
You would have me fight such a battle with our numbers. Are you gone mad?
I mislike your tone.
Forgive me, Your Grace. We are more powerful now than ever, I grant you. But let us not forget, we failed to rouse the Galgastani against Balbatos. Our resistance remains far outmatched.
I do not need you to tell me what I know so well.
Then I beg you to reconsider.
Humor, your Duke. Hear my plan before you reject it, First, we dispatch a light force to secure Balmamusa, a small town southwest of Caritani. Thence to advance to the Zeod Moors.
You distract them by needling their flank? They will never fall for such a ruse.
Your ears would serve me better than your tongue. I mean to have our young hero lead the band. We will feed sweet lies to their whisperers, that it's no small band, but half our army that marches. A morsel they will find impossible to resist. Nor will they know whether it is from Almorica or Balmamusa that we strike.
And they will believe this tale.
The presence of the hero of Goliath will convince them. Balbatos would not think we place our hero at the head of so few. This will be enough to give Balbatos pause. But he is no fool. He will not commit the entirety of his forces to Balmamusa. No, he will divide his men between the Sonji Weald and the Zeod Moors. The martial advantage is his. Even with his forces split, he will not fear defeat. Yet only this way will we have a true chance at victory.
Perhaps. But if Balbatos does not split his troops, what then?
We must see that he does. There's more. Once our heroes have a foothold in Balmamusa, they will turn their attentions to the port of Ashton to the west. Balbatos will fear an assault, and with his troops mustering in Caritani, Ashton will be ripe for the taking.
Of course. Without Balmamusa or Ashton, they'll be cut off from the sea.
Is that so great a blow?
In Valeria, the sea is life. Without the bounty of her trade, we wither and die. Doubly so, the Galgastani and their landlocked keep at Caritani. Believe our rumors or no, they must respond. And that means splitting their troops.
Should the gambit fail, we still weaken them by closing their ports.
What becomes of us?
If you sense disadvantage, withdraw swiftly.
So in the end, we still must fight a battle of Galgastan's choosing.
Oh, you fret like an old maid, Leonar. The plan is perfect.
As you say, Your Grace.
Forward! Leave no Galgastani standing!
Thank you.
Zayard Moors are within our grasp. Onward!